9? We must be slipping.
Hello.
Good morning.
Is the boss in yet?
I hadn't seen Mr. Kent this morning.
Maybe you blinked and missed him.
Possibly.
Mr. Gould wants to see Mr. Kent. Oh, I'll put that in my memory book. Now, forget the cats, will you? If you don't let up, you're going to meow yourself into a padded cell.
Oh, bring Harry for me, will you?
Skulking Thompson.
What have you got against him?
Just don't like him, that's all.
Sometimes I get the feeling you don't like anybody.
If you only knew.
Here's a girl for you.
What kind of a girl?
Brains. You can buy beautiful women a dime a dozen. She's got up here.
So have I.
What?
A headache.
Half a dozen of the chorus people here as models. Teaching new kids the steps. Like it?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I do. Say, I tell you somebody who'd be swell for a job like that.
Who?
Bee Thorne.
No, too valuable where she is.
Oh, but she's a swell dancer. Used to do turn vaudeville.
No, I don't think she'd be interested.
Whatever you say, boss. That looks vaguely familiar. Remember now, you can only stay till Aunt Clara or somebody or something comes through. Who is it? Well, just a minute. You answer the door. Anything special?
Oh, I got some new ideas in that cat stuff. One of the outline.
It's on the desk.
Most prologues, Mr. Kent, are utterly commonplace. But yours, yours have meaning. What was it Ruskin said? That intangible something.
Oh, Vivian, whatever happened to that boyfriend of yours? Is he still a bootlegger?
Man is so bourgeois at times.
Swell gal, though. Works like a slave.
Nice of you to drop in. Hello? Four girls from the Swiss Navy unit married a quartet in Philadelphia yesterday and they want to quit.
Quartet any good?
Is the quartet any good? Yeah.
Put them in the act.
Put them in the act.
This is Miss Rich, my secretary, Miss Prescott.
I know Miss Rich, if you remember.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I met her at your place.
Uh-huh.
Vivian is the head of our new style and ID department.
I hope you'll both be very happy.
Oh, Nan, I've got a date for lunch. Phone Miss Rich and tell her I'll be right over, will you?
Miss Rich, please.
Miss Rich? I'm calling for Mr. Kent. Yes, he won't be able to have lunch with you. No, he says you may take the afternoon off. He doesn't want you to strain yourself the first day.
No, just dreaming lazily about life.
Tell me, where do you get your hair done and where do you get all those pretty dresses?
What's the idea?
Well, you're the type men like and me.
Know any more funny stories?
You can think out loud.
Like we used to?
It might help. Keep throwing ideas at me.
And you throw the penguins right back. Mm-hmm. Sold. We'll give Apollo a show if it takes all night.
Hello?
Who's speaking? Nan?
Nobody else. I wouldn't think of waking him. He's sleeping. And so was I when you called. Goodbye, dear. Move over, Chester, darling.
You get up here. This is a chance of a lifetime.
All right, I'll go. But I want you to know I resent this.
How dare you, my fiancé?
Now you scram before I wrap a chair around your neck.
But it's 3 o'clock in the morning. Where do you want me to go?
All right.
Listen, you chief stenographer.
Outside, Countess. As long as they have sidewalks, you've got a job. Hey, wait a minute. This is Mr. Kent's private office.
How nice. I'm Mrs. Kent.
And I'm Lydia Pinkham, outside. Do you know this dizzy dame?
Yeah, I still have nightmares about her. She used to be my wife.
There is a Santa Claus.
25 G's are made out to you.
Endorsed to Chester Kent. Take it and ask no questions.
There's something phony here. How'd you get it?
Blackmail.
Come on, spill it.
I played a pair of deuces like four aces and they paid.
I certainly have a genius of picking names to fall for.
You said it, Papa.
Maybe you better help me next time.
What do you think I've been doing?
This idea's for a wedding.
For a unit?
No, for you and me.
Come on, take another bow.
Take it yourself. You like it?
Whatever you say, boss.
I'll make you love it.